working for the ICA. Unknowingly, they have been hired by a shadow client to target a number of operatives of Providence, a secret organization working in the highest echelons of power. Providence's controller, the Constant, approaches Diana and makes her a deal. Eliminate the shadow client and learn about 47's past. But when 47 discovers that the shadow client is Lucas Gray, his lost childhood friend, he and Diana switch sides to fulfill an old pact. Destroy Providence. Together, they manage to capture the Constant, forcing him to reveal the identities of the three Providence partners. Eliminate them, and the war would be over. However, the Constant has an ace up his sleeve. Look closer. In the shadows. Behind the everyday world. Beyond the headlines and the seats of power. A hidden hand. A kind of company known as Providence. To it, we were just assets to use and throw away, to do the unthinkable, the unforgivable, and it never gave us a second thought until now. After decades in the shadows, we are fighting back. Me and 47. Much has been lost, but we are closer than ever. We trapped the Constant, Providence's chief controller, and finally learned the names of its three partners. In their downfall, we lay the past to rest. And, just maybe, look towards the future.
47. It's time. Partners are down there. You know, I never planned this far ahead.
You never do.
I see someone got his memory back. Wait, is that a beacon? What the hell? Base. Lexa Carlyle's helicopter just took off. Confirm target locations. Over.
Diana, what's the status?
Right. We have a situation. Carlyle has left the building. And I think I know why. The Constant has escaped. He persuaded one of the sailors into setting him free. And since then, he's been seizing control of Providence assets and resources. I can only assume Carlyle is rushing to contain the damage.
If she slips away again...
We'll keep track of her. Make sure she doesn't. Meanwhile, the plan stays the same. Your destination is the Scepter, the world's tallest building where the partners are laying low, courtesy of their host, Sheikh Omar al-Ghazali. Marcus Stuyvesant is fifth-generation old money. His family made its fortune in real estate and banking, and were at one point the chief landowners in New York. Carl Ingram is a powerful Washington kingmaker whose family grew rich selling gunpowder during the American Civil War, and later established a globe-spanning empire in oil, coal, and steel. Both families long since retreated from public view, but their quiet dominance endures to this day. Now, the partners likely suspect that we're coming, so Mr. Gray will infiltrate building controls and disable all electronic doors and elevators. Stuyvesant and Ingram are about to find they have nowhere left to run.
Right. This is our moment, 47. Providence ruined our lives with the flick of a pen. Today, we return the favor. Happy hunting.
Welcome to the barge, Alcazar.
Welcome! Welcome. Hello! Good to see you. How lovely to see so many familiar faces here today. This has been a dream of mine for a great many years. It has always been from one of the less sides of the respectable Alcazar. But with a
would ya?
Just a precaution.
I've been personally invited by the Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali. I should have clearance. The name is Zaina Kazim.
Sir, I understand. You can't enter without being searched. It's standard procedure. This is
ridiculous. Wow, that's
horrible. Oh, yeah.
Think about it.
I could get used to a gig like this.
I'll be waiting up.
47. I would like to address the Providence partners directly. I want them to know why this is happening. And I have an idea, but it requires you finding a map terminal.
Wow. Come in. I've heard something weird. I'm gonna go check it out. All is cool. Thank you.
new guard assigned a codename Pinky.
I got word that he entered the building, but he hasn't reported for duty yet.
Probably still down at the depot, getting his uniform.
Excuse me. Has my replacement guard turned up yet?
We still haven't heard from him yet. But we know he's in the building. I'm sure he's just waiting for his uniform, and he'll be up soon.
I'm glad to hear, but I don't like to be kept waiting. Make sure he has his papers and call me, okay?
I'll be sure to contact you as soon as he turns up. Papers vetted and all.
Get him up here, or I'll make a personal complaint to His Royal Highness, and you don't want that.
Stuyvesant is expecting a replacement guard. If you can locate him, we should be able to get within strangling distance of the little worm.
Be here. I'm getting some help. Someone needs to teach you something. Hey, get your head out of your ass. Something horrible has happened.
We tolerate no trash. Stop right there. Sir, you have to follow me right now. Are we clear? You're free to go. Don't let me see you here again.
Thank you.
people.
What's the update on my new guard? My current one has been on duty for way too long. I need security that's sharp and focused.
Sir, we have word that he's arrived. I'm just waiting for him to turn up.
Good. Remember to check his papers before you call me. I don't want some snot-nosed newbie.
Of course, sir. We'll let you know.
Good. And please, when I come back, no more excuses. I'm a personal friend of His Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali.
Stuyvesant is expecting a replacement guard. If you can locate him, we should be able to get within strangling distance of the little worm.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Crazy manager called us into another meeting, so now we've got to memorize the list. colleague is also out there.
I mean, I'm in my boxers, and you are a woman. It's just so embarrassing.
Oh, it's nothing I haven't seen before.
But you don't understand. I'm military. We military men are just a punctuality. I was supposed to be ready to present my papers half an hour ago.
Yes, you men in the army with your business.
Okay, it's back to business as usual.
I get it.
Are you making fun of me? That's so cruel. Do you know what a man is without his gun?
A man in his boxers, crying like a baby.
Ugh, you women will never understand.
And I don't think we ever will. I can't find it. Can't you just wear a waiter uniform? It would be pretty effective if you wanted to blend in.
What? Are you trying to be my mother? My God, no! I need to dress professionally and show... My papers! Do you not understand that?
Okay. I'll keep looking.
Thank you. Well, maybe you should look somewhere else. I mean, you haven't found it yet.
Patience. It's here somewhere.
I think I can open that window remotely. Scan the lock with your camera and I'll have a try.
What was that?
Was that it?
Huh?
With the strangling, moron! Stop that right now! Eat this, you bastard! Don't let him get away! You shouldn't be here!
Man, I just heard a weird noise. I'm moving in to investigate.
I think I can open that window remotely. Scan the lock with your camera and I'll have a try.
Not another one. This is a disgrace, really.
Call up the press with a news story. And finally, the food is for guests only. Unless you're a chef, there's no such thing as tasting. I think we all recall what happened at the grand opening of Sheikh Omar's solar panel plant last year. Nobody wore white for 5 months after that incident. Oh, one last...
Hello, sir.
Reporting for duty.
About time. Our client has been going out of his mind waiting for you. Do you have the papers?
Yes.
Good. I'll call him now.
How should I address him?
It's classified, so you don't call him anything. But officially, he's just known as codename Pinky. Sir, this is security. Just calling to let you know your new guard has finally arrived. Yes, sir. See you soon. Okay, wait here. He'll be here shortly. Mumbai. I heard that was a shitstorm. It's good to see a man like you back in the saddle.
Okay, you must be my new escort. I have very high standards, and trust you will do your duty. You have your credentials on you? Well, this all looks very promising. Yes? Good. Oh, you worked for Dawood Rangan. Hope you weren't there on the day of his tragic death. Okay, this all looks very good. Come on, let's walk. Need to tell you a bit about what I expect from you.
Greetings, sir.
I expect you to be by my side 24/7, unless I say otherwise. Bathroom breaks are, of course, permitted, but only when I say so. I have a very important, delicate meeting today, at which I expect you to keep your ears closed, but your eyes wide open. Understood? Now, your papers were indeed impressive, but I need to see what you can do with my own eyes. My father used to take me hunting. He was an avid hunter. I personally hated it, but always admired his skill with a knife, and grew to appreciate what it takes to gut an animal. Have you ever tried to gut an animal?
Yes.
Good. Then you know it's not so easy as it looks. Like trying to stab a rubber ball. It bounces back if you don't stab it correctly. You're almost here. You have to understand. I didn't get where I am by blind faith. Okay, we are almost there. You see the shooting targets? Any fool can shoot a target. But with a knife? That's where the talent lies. My father always used to say, if you are good with a knife, you're even better with a gun. I want to see your skills. I don't know why, but I've always trusted a man who would throw a knife. I'm sure a psychiatrist would have a field day with that statement. Stop fooling around. I don't have all day. Yes, I like you. I think we will get along just fine.
You've gained his trust.
I think I got the right man now.
What to do
Thank
with all that power?
I'll take the rest of the day off. You deserve it.
Thank you, sir. It was an honor. Thank you, sir.
You impressed me. You really did. But let's get to work. Some things you should know about me, and this is very much on a need-to-know basis. Maybe. Yeah, Inco. So I want you to stay close, but not too close. Especially when we are out in public. If you see a man with a bodyguard, it draws attention. Understood? Yeah, of course you do. Come on, follow me.
You got him, 47. Marcus Stuyvesant won't be a problem anymore. Let's move on to Carl Ingram. We're not done yet.
our possible intruder commences sweep. Out.
Oh, you pilot the heli out there. Look, I'm afraid I can't let you through here. I'm sorry, my friend.
No noise of any kind.
Okay, but it means I'll work slower.
I don't care what tempo you work.
It will be slow. And I'll probably get a warning about that.
You can't be here, sir. Sir.
What?
What are you doing?
No more hate, people. Alpha, move on target.
What are you doing? You can't be here.
Hey, wake up. I think we
I already told you to... Don't move!
Look,
you need to follow me right now. No questions. Move it. Hey, you. Are you deaf? Follow me.
This is bad.
You should...
Hey.
Listen. I got four tally marks tattooed.
Get
behind
me. Stay low.
Whoa!
his head.
I need help.
Oh.
Right away! God. Principal has been shot!
Looks like we got trouble! Stay low and follow my lead! This is ridiculous. I want quiet. I want peace. But you idiots don't understand that. Well, I'll make sure His Royal Highness fires all of you. I'm going to the study. This is ridiculous.
Your unwanted items here, mister. Namaste.
To our failures. Vanity is power's greatest foe, which has been proven time and time again. Throughout history.
Not bad. I need a break, though.
Okay, where was I? However, even we are not bulletproof, as has been proven with recent events. No, I don't believe our current dilemma is caused by vanity or arrogance or even laziness. But something worse. We were lured by the serpent of the darkness.
around you on a woodworn
page. Hello, sir. Huh?
Working for the hand that fed him.
Hey!
waiter!
You!
Sir, I'm talking to you, sir!
I don't buy the getup, pal.
How could you even think that would work? Hey, psych! Hey!
I need a shot! They appear! Deadly force neutralized! She liked whate'er she looked on, and her looks went everywhere.
How much do I need to pay you to just follow me?
Like this through wind and rain, and watch the sand and feel the boulevard break again to warmth.
light.
How about this one? She had a heart, how shall I say? Too soon.
Okay. Recruiting. Only a fool would assume that power can be kept by only a few good men. And women. We might be the chess masters, but we need our chess pieces to keep the balance. And, like all the great chess masters of our time, patience is the key. This is the fundamental rule in recruiting. Explain. I would like to share a story, a fable, if you will. Little Jeffrey, a lonely boy who came from a less than modest home, showed from an early age signs of great intelligence and inventiveness, something that no one noticed but his teacher. Now, thanks to her keen eye, she began to push little Jeffrey harder, believing he could make something of himself.
That's enough for now. Sick.
We got him, 47. Soon there will be no more Providence. You need to find an exit. Our business is done here, but it's far. Over.
Is it nearly done?
Are you kidding me? No, it needs to simmer. Perfection. Must not be disturbed. You speed it up. You bring all the glory of life.
that's your winning face, I'd hate to see you lose.
We underestimated the Constant.
Yeah, he's a glorified desk clerk.
He's not just after the money. He wants it all.
We caught him once, we can do it again. And, well, we're not the ones who let him escape.
You still don't trust her.
I don't like executive decision makers. Look, you don't have to follow her, you know? Soon, this will be over. Maybe it's time to think about the future. You have to face the possibility that there's no going back. If the ICA knows what you did,
she'll make it right. She always does.
We have a fix on Carlisle. Come on. We've got a plane to catch. I hope you like the rain, 47.
Miss Burnwood.
How did you...
I have everyone's number. You really ought to know by now.
You planned this. All of it.
Don't be silly. I just played the hand I was dealt.
We'll find you.
You had me. Where'd that get you?
We handed you an empire.
It's for the best. The partners were complacent, set in their ways. But power is more than just security. Providence can be an agent of change. Surely you understand. Or you will. Soon enough.